So today we're going to have a summary of the lessons learned from week one to week six. My name is Anne, and then I'm going to teach you what we've learned so far. Now, let's see what we learned on week one. Now, week one of our class, we learned on the introduction to ICT. Good. Now we want to know what the meaning of I, the meaning of C, the meaning of T is. Okay, let's see what it is. Now, I stands for information. The letter I in ICT stands for information. Now, when you need a message, when you need to know about what is happening in your community or in your society, now, mommy or daddy or even you, you watch the TV to know what is happening, and then you get the message of whatever you need to know. That is what information is all about. So letter I stands for word information. Now let's go straight to letter C. The letter C stands for communication. What is communication? When I need to speak to mom and dad, it's a means of talking to people, talking with your friends, talking with your family members, like your uncle, your aunt, your niece, your nephew, anybody. That means you're communicating with them. So the C stands for communication. The C stands for word communication, and the letter T stands for technology. Now, looking at that, we have a computer in front of at the side. Computer is a form of technology. Even your phone, your home theater, they're all forms of technology. Now, let's do it one more time. Letter I stands for information. Letter C stands for communication. Letter T stands for technology. I'm gonna say it one more time. Letter I stands for information. Letter C stands for communication. Letter T stands for technology. All together we have ICT. Okay, so this time around, I want you to close your eyes and we are going to say the full meaning of ICT. Let's go. I stands for information. C stands for communication. T stands for technology. Wow! So roll it out for yourself. Roll it, and let it go. Good. For myself. Good. So right now, let's move to week two of our lesson. Yeah. So in week two, we're going to learn about the different ICT devices that we have. Now let's look at what we have. Yay! Now here are some of the ICT devices that we have. Here are some of the ICT devices that we have. Now, the first one is a telephone. A telephone is an ICT device. And what do we use our telephone for? We use it to talk with mommy, daddy. We use it to communicate. Remember we said that the same ICT stands for communication. So this telephone is used for communicating. I talk with mom, I talk with dad, using the terry form. The next one is a computer system. Yep. We use the computer system to do a whole lot of things. Without computer, ICT is not possible. So we need computer a whole lot. Now, the next one is our home theater. In our home theater, we have a television, we have a radio, we have a speaker. Now, all of these together is called the home theater. And whenever we need to know about anything, we can listen to any of these and watch it. And then it passes the information that we need. Remember that I is information, and this is one of the ways we pass information, or this is one of the ways we get to know about some things. The next one is a digital wristwatch. Yep. Now, the digital wristwatch you wear on your wrist is a form of it's an example of an ICT device. It tells us the time. Now, the last one is
a traffic light.
This is a traffic light. Let's remember a traffic light. There are three colors for the traffic light. The red light says stops, the yellow light says get ready, and the green light says go, 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 and go. Now, the traffic light tells you when to move, when to stay, and when to get ready. So all of these are some of the ICT devices that we know, and we also see them. We use them. Right now, we're going to mention some of the ICT devices one more time. The first one is a phone. The second one is a computer. The third one is a home theater. The fourth is a digital wristwatch. And the last one is a traffic light. So, will you tell me, Coach Ice, now tell me just like three of them. Okay. Traffic lights, computer, a telephone, a digital wristwatch, and a telephone. Good job. That is a very, very good job. Good. Now, let's write on to week three and see what we learned in week three of our class. Yes. In week three, we have computer and its parts. This is a computer system, a complete computer system. And then we're going to know the different parts of the computer system. This is a different part. Now, firstly, before we talk about the different part, what is a computer system? A computer system is an electronic machine that can do so many things. A computer system is an electronic machine that can do so many things. One more time, a computer system is an electronic machine that can do so many things. We say a computer system is an electronic machine because it uses electricity. We need to charge it. We need to use electricity to charge our laptop. Our desktop computer cannot work when there is no power. So it uses electricity. And a computer system can do so many things, like it can be used for typing, we can use it to play our game, we can use it to watch our videos. So for the last time, we're going to say what a computer system is. A computer system is an electronic machine that can do so many things. A computer system is an electronic machine that can do so many things. So right now we're going to know the four major parts of the computer system. The four major parts of the computer system are, the first one is a mouse. The first one is a what again? A mouse. A mouse. The second is a system unit. Let's take that again. The second is a system unit. The third one is a keyboard. The third one is a keyboard. And the last one is a monitor. Can we do that one more time? The first one is a mouse. The second is a system unit. The third one is a keyboard. And the last one is a monitor. So let me teach you a song on the part of computer system. Part of computer, monitor, system unit, keyboard, and mouse. Let's do that again. It's a very simple song. Part of computer, monitor, system unit, keyboard, and mouse. Let's do that for the last time. Part of computer, monitor, the system unit, keyboard, and a mouse. Good job. Thank you so much. Let's clap ourselves for singing the song together. Slowly, slowly, and let it go. Good. For myself. Good. So right now that we know the different parts of the computer system, let's see what we learned in week four of our class. Let's see what we learned in week four. We're learning one part of the computer system, and that is a system unit. A system unit, good. Now, let's know about the system unit. The system unit is the most important part of the computer. Why do we say it's the most important part of the computer? Because every other part of the computer are connected to the system unit. Now, let me ask you, can you remember some of the computer parts I mentioned earlier? A mouse, a monitor, and a keyboard. Good job. Let's just, now all of these parts that we mentioned earlier are connected to the system unit. All of these parts are connected to the system unit. So that makes the system unit so very important. That means the system unit so what? Very important. Now, there are two types of system units. The third one is called the tower system unit. The third one you can see in my picture is called tower system unit. Why the one next to it, the flat one, is called a desktop system unit. How many types of system unit did I say we have? Two types. The first one is tower system unit, and the second is desktop system unit. Good job. The first one is tower system unit, and the second one is desktop system unit. Now, as you can see in my slide, there is a place I put an arrow, that is the power button. That is the power button. Right here is the power button. Now, the power button, or you can say switch on button. The power button is used to switch on the computer system. The power button is used to switch on the computer system. Now, you use the power button to switch on, but you do not use the power button to shut down. Do we get it? Because you are not, you're going to spoil the laptop when you use the power button to shut it down. So whenever you need to shut down, I'm going to teach you that later, or just know that you do not use the power button to shut down. You only use the power button to switch on the computer system. Now, before I move to the next slide, let's mention the two types of system units again. The tower system unit and the desktop system unit. Good job. Okay, so let's move over learning. Next slide.
Whoa. This is called the CPU.
Now, the system unit has a component, a part that is inside, just like okay, this system unit right here has the CPU inside of it. Now, and this CPU is called the brain of the computer. The brain of the computer. Now, let me ask you a question. What do you use your brain for? We can use our brain to think, to store information. Good. So also, a computer has a CPU that is used for storing information, that is used for accepting information. And then when it accepts the information, it will keep it. And this CPU, just like the brain is inside your head, the CPU is also inside the system unit. Okay, I have a song for that. Are you ready to hear my song? Yeah. The brain of the computer is CPU. 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 The brain of the computer is CPU. Central processing unit. The C stands for central, the P stands for processing, and the U stands for units. Let's take some one more time. The brain of the computer is CPU, CPU, CPU. The brain of the computer is CPU, central processing units. So let us know that. Okay, let me ask you a question. Where is the brain of the computer found? Where is the brain of the computer found? It is found in the system unit. Good job. That is very good. So the brain of the computer is found in the system unit. So that takes us. That's the end for week four. Okay, this is week four lesson. Oh, you're not tired of my class. I'm sure you're enjoying it. All right. Now, so down now we have the week 5 and week 6 lesson, which is on the mouse. We're talking about the mouse. When are we talking about the mouse? The mouse is like the hand of the computer. Okay, like what do we use our hand for? Okay, let's look at our own hand. What do we use our hand for? We can use our hand to grab. We can use our hand to eat. We can use our hand to hold something. Now, whenever the computer system needs to perform anything, it uses the mouse. So the mouse, let's look at the different things, the three things that we use the mouse for. We use the mouse to select. Now, we use the mouse to select. Now, when you need to select, the select means to use the mouse and then I'm trying to select this word. Yes, I've actually used my mouse to select that word over there. Okay, let me use it to select this. Yes, this is what it means to select. So we use our mouse to select. Now the next one is we use our mouse to click. Can you see I'm clicking with the mouse? I'm clicking with the mouse. I'm clicking with the mouse. So right here, I'm clicking with the mouse. So what I'm using here is to use my mouse to click. Yes, we're using the mouse to click. Now the next thing is we can use the mouse to drag and drop. Okay, let me take this mouse over here. I'm going to drag my mouse. I'm going to drag it. Where should I drop it? Let me drop the mouse right here. Good. Now, let me do it one more time. Let me drag my mouse. Now, if you have a mouse, okay, can you use? I'm going to drag my mouse and then I'll drop it here. So that is what it means to drag and drop. Now let's mention the three functions of the mouse again. The first one is to select. The second is to click. The third is to drag and drop. Okay, one more time. To select. To click, to drag, and drop. I want you to close your eyes, and then we're going to say it together. Number one, to select. Number two, to click. Number three, to drag, and drop. Good job. That is very, very good. Now let's look at what we have. Next slide. Good. There are three parts of a mouse. There are three parts of a mouse, and they have the right click, the left click, and the scroll button. This is the right click, the left click, and the scroll button. These are the three parts of a mouse. The three parts of a mouse are the right click, the left click, and the scroll button. Use our right hand, right click, left click, and the scroll button. That means we can right click with the mouse, we can left click with the mouse, or we can scroll using the mouse. Okay, for the last time, the three parts of the mouse are right click, and the scroll button. So now we're going to talk about the cursor. The cursor shows the direction of the mouse. When you move the mouse to any direction, the cursor will also put on the screen. Look at my cursor. I'm going to put my cursor right here. Can you see my cursor is moving? That is telling you the direction of your mouse. This right here, showing the direction of my mouse. Can you see something moving on the screen? Look at the shape and look at the shape of my cursor. Yes, that is a cursor. It's showing the direction of where of my mouse. So the moment you move your mouse, the cursor also moves. The cursor is just like the shadow of a mouse. It's showing where the mouse is. Thank you. So that's it. So what shows the direction of your mouse is the cursor. Okay, now let's. Yes, now we're going to learn how to use the left key to shut down the computer. Remember I told you that the mouse has three parts. The first one is the right click, the second is the left click, and the third is the scroll button. Now, we're going to learn how to use the left click of a mouse to shut down the computer. Now, Darren is telling me that we should move to the next slide. So let's move to the next slide to know how we're going to shut down the computer system. Now, the first thing you do is to locate the start button. So I want you to watch me. I'm going to locate my own start button. Look at the icon for the start button, okay? Let me show you. This is my icon for start button. So I'm going to look at my laptop or my computer system or my desktop or tablet computer system and then click on the start button. Yes, this is my start button. But you know, if I should start this way, I'm going to shut down my computer and the meeting is going to end. So I will just need to show you how to do it and then you do this after I'm done with this class. Okay, the first one is to click on the start button. Now, the second is to locate the power button. Let's move here, click on the start button, and then you click right here. That is the power button. Remember, the first step is locate the start button. The second step is locate the power button. After the power button, let's see the next step. The next step is we should click on shut down. The next step says click on shut down. So let's go back to the start button, just like this. Come here to the start button. After the start button is the power button. And then when I click on my power button, I'll just click on my shut down. And then the system is going to go off. But you know, I cannot shut down my computer right now because I'm teaching with this. So that is how to shut down the computer system. Remember the last earlier on, I told you, you do not shut down the computer system using the power button. Right now, I've taught you how to use the left click to shut down the computer system. So I'm giving you a task now. Immediately I'm done with this class, I want you to get a computer system and then shut down. Okay, you switch on using the power button and then you shut down using the power button. Sorry, using the start button. Let me say that again. After watching this video, I want you to get a computer system, switch it on using the power button, and then shut down using the start button.
Promise me you're going to do that. All right. Okay. Oh, wow. This takes us to the end of the class. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it. Bye.